Hey there! Welcome to another episode of Dear Blocko. This is the show where I answer your questions that you have about your world and my world. Let's get started. Ian J asks, Dear Blocko, what would happen if you stepped on a rusty nail? Oof. Well, besides the immense pain that I'm sure you'd be experiencing, people often say that getting injured by rusty nails and other rusted sharp objects can cause tetanus. This is because the bacteria that causes tetanus, Clostridium tetani, is found in soil, dust, and animal feces, places where you also often find rusty objects. Once the bacteria enters your bloodstream through a wound, the spores produce a toxin that impairs your brain and nervous system. This can lead to stiff muscles, difficulty swallowing, and spasms so powerful they can tear muscles. The good news is that it's very easy to treat and even prevent. If diagnosed, there is medication that can be administered to kill the bacteria, and the tetanus vaccine can be given to children at a very early age. After that, you just need a booster shot every 10 years to remain tetanus-free. AwesomeDude196 asks, Dear Blocko, why do we stop growing after a certain point? Well, as we reach the end of puberty, which I'm sure is a huge relief for some of us, the growth plates in our bones mature and eventually fuse, stopping any further growth. Your final height is determined by a combination of general health and nutrition, but primarily by your genes. In fact, scientists have found that the genes you inherit from your parents can account for up to 80% of your final height. Your growth and sex hormones can also have an effect, with too much or too little causing you to be shorter or taller than normal. The tallest man in the world, reaching 2.7 meters, had a pituitary condition that resulted in an overproduction of his growth hormone. However, his height caused a number of medical issues with his legs that led to a tragically early death at just 22 years old. Man, sorry to end with a bummer, but anyway, now it's time to answer questions about me and my world. 8-Bit Raptor asks, Dear Blocko, in your world, can you do whatever you want, or does the animator control everything? I think I can do whatever I want. I've said before that my animator can change whatever at a moment's notice, but I'm pretty free to wander, explore, and mess up. I have to put in a request for new areas, though. So much red tape to go through. Ugh. If there's a place that you want me to make in my world, please let me know down below. My animator is itching for a new construction project. Cody McKee asks, Dear Blocko, how do your guests, like Ginger Pale, enter your world? Well, if you're an animation YouTuber, I believe you enter through this giant portal in the sky. And if you're not an animation, then I'm pretty sure you flush yourself down a toilet to get to my world. At least in my world, toilets are portals to the real world. I'm assuming they're a similar situation for you. Don't actually try to flush yourself down the toilet, please. I've made some modifications to my toilet portal, by the way, and I think I'm almost ready to enter the real world again. It's gonna get good. Do you have any questions about your world or my world? Let me know in the comment section below and make sure you use the hashtag DearBlocko so I can find it. Enjoyed this episode of Dear Blocko? Why don't you check out the previous one we did? Dear Blocko, why is the moon sometimes red when the Earth's moon looks orangey-brown or red, also sometimes referred to as a blood moon? It's because your moon is in a total lunar eclipse. As always, my name is Blocko. This has been Life Noggin. Don't forget to keep on thinking.